Hi and welcome back to another episode of the greatest book club in the world, the AK Book Club. And today we are on episode number 14. And guys, today's video is going to be shorter than usual because I had a really long day and it's coming too late. And I tired, so I don't have the power to make like a full hour. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to read tips. Today is tips number 27 and 28. I'm going to read it, and that's it. So let's enjoy. And I do this episode because, you know, I told you that I'm going to do it each day. I'm going to upload an episode. So I'm going to make sure that no matter what, I'll do my best to provide you and bring you a new content each day, like 5 days a week. And so let's do it. My name is AK. A poem piece from this blog, from this book club, from this podcast is one, to improve my English speaking level and reading level. Two, to improve my skills in standing in front of the, in speaking in front of the camera, to be more confident, to learn from it, to become better. So when is the time for me, when is the time comes that it's my time to shine, I will be ready for it, for my opportunity. And the third reason is to inspire the people around the world to open their own podcast and to improve their English, because as you see, as you hear, I'm not a native English speaker. I'm from Israel, so I have a really strong Israeli accent. The diction is not so good. And I'm working on improving it today, improve it a little bit. And on each day, I improve it a little bit more and more and more and more. And this is my reason that I'm doing this podcast. And of course, having a good time. So let's go, let's do it, let's go. Tip number 27, under the kimono, my best practices. I just want to help you shine. All I really care about is doing my part to help you get to your greatness, to help you reach your best at work, to help you find happiness at home, to help you make your mark. What's my payoff? Well, when I help you live your finest life, I get to feel significant. I get to feel significant. I get to feel that I'm making a difference in the world, that I matter, that I'm not walking on the planet in vain, that I'm not walking the planet in vain. That is where so much of my happiness comes from, truly. So here is what I thought about in the shower this morning. What are my best practices? In other words, what are the best things that I do to stay at my very best, on game and in potential, and in potential? Here's what I came up with. And I'll give it for Robin, quick, because I have to speak. I can't help myself. My quick, I said it. Well, never mind. But I'm also really like to think in the shower. I think it's the best place. It's the best place to think, and have a really great idea when I'm shower. And type in the comment if you also have a really great time in the shower thinking. Here's what I came up with. Up at 5 a.m. 5 times a week, with naps on the weekends. In 60 minutes every hour, once I'm up, for self-development and personal reflection. 5 time workout a week. A 90-minute massage every 7 days. I would like it. If there's any volunteer to come to massage me, give me a massage 90 minutes or more on each day, you're more than welcome to come. A world-class diet, but I eat 1 or 2 desserts every week. Life isn't meant to be too strict. And if I ever see flowers and chocolate cake on a menu, I order it. A period of journaling most days. Journaling builds self-awareness. I also use my journal to write daily goals, plan and record what I'm grateful for, and captures and process new ideas along with lessons learned. A period of reading each day, from Harvard Business Review to travel and leisure to the well and good books. Affirmations or what I call success statements for the day, especially in the shower. Those keep my thoughts locked on what's most important. And thoughts are my ancestors of action. And thoughts are the ancestors of action, of actions. Right thinking drives right action. A weekly planning sessions. I also review my goals here. Usually I do it Sunday morning. At least one conversation with an interesting people, a person, each week to keep my passion high and to surround myself with big ideas. A single conversation can change your life. In an issue of Business 2.0, management consultant Jim Collins revealed that one idea shared in 30 seconds by a mentor transformed him. Big line, this very day can be the first day of your new life. It's all your choice. I have more, but those are my best personal practices. The ones that bring out my highest. Pick the ones that resonate with you. Discard the ones that you disagree with. Just find what works for the way you live. Then act on them today. This very day can be the first day of your new life. It's all of your choice. Tip number 28. Tip number 28. Need to wake up myself. Culture is skin. At a leadership training program I recently gave for a group of high-tech managers, a distinguished-looking man came up to me at that break and shared, "I love what you said about the need for each one of us, to develop a leadership culture within our organizations." At our company, one of our top priorities is to work on our culture. We talk about it all the time. Last year, our company grew 600%. Our focus on culture building worked splendidly. Impressive. As I've suggested earlier, one of your most sustainable one of your most sustainable competitive advantages will be developing a culture of leadership. When clients engage Sharma Leadership International for organizational development and employee training, one of the first areas AREAS we focused on is developing the company's culture. Because our performance is driven by the culture. Your competitors will copy your products if they are good. They will copy your services. They will copy your branding, but they will never be able to copy your culture. And our culture is the very thing that makes your organization special. The organization's culture is what sets and then drives the standards of behavior. Your culture tells your people what's acceptable and important. Your culture lets people know what your organization's value, e.g., honesty, innovation, unending improvement, growing customers. Collaboration, candor, and so on. Your organization's culture states its philosophy, its mythology, its religion. To me, culture is skin. big grinds. One of your most sustainable competitive advantage will be developing what I call a culture of leadership. The five best ways to build culture are the follows. Rituals. I like the cult in culture. The best companies like Dell and Google and Southwest Airlines and Apple and Walmart have something in common with cults. They have unique ritual like 7 a.m. team huddles or Friday afternoon pizza parties to promote team bonding. Ritual shapes culture and keep it special. Celebration. John Abel, founder of the multi-billion dollar Boston Scientific, once told me over dinner that you get what you celebrate. Powerful idea. When you see someone living the values your culture stands for, make them a public hero. Behavior that gets rewarded is behavior that gets repeated. Catch people doing good. Number three, conversation. Your people become what the leaders talk about. To get your vision and the values into your people's hearts, you need to be talking about that stuff constantly. At employee gathering, at your weekly meeting, during your daily huddles, and at the water cooler, and at the water cooler. You need to evangelize what you stand for constantly. In this excellent book, Winning, Jack Welch says that he spent so much time evangelizing GE's missions, maybe General Electric vision missions, that he could call his people at 3 in the morning and half asleep. They could restate it. He never did it. Training. A mission and a critical focus to build a culture is employee development. If you agree that your organization's number one resource is your people, then it only makes sense to invest significantly in developing your number one resource. Hold seminars and dev leadership workshops to instill the values you seek to nurture and build a leadership culture into their hearts and minds. When your people improve, your company will improve. Number five, storytelling. Great companies have cultures where great stories are told from generation to generation. The story about how the company was founded in the basement, or the story about how a teammate went the extra mile and delivered the customer's baby, or the story about how the organization found back to victory from the brink of a disaster. Storytelling comments a company's most closely cherished ideals into the hearts of its people. People want to go to work each day and feel they are a part of a community. One of the deepest psychological needs of a human being is the need for belonging. It's important to read it one more time. One of the deepest psychological needs of a human being is the need for belonging, to feel belonging. We also want to work for an organization that values us, that promotes our personal growth, and that makes us feel that we are contributing contributing. And that makes us feel that we are contributing to a dream. Geddes feels right by creating a culture of a leadership. Geddes feels right by creating a culture of leadership, and you will keep your stars and attract other ones. And wouldn't that be perfect? So this is for today, guys. I really hope you enjoy it. Sorry, but I feel really tired. So tip number 27. Anna Zakimon is my best practice, but he give us his daily ritual. That's helping him to improve himself. Tip number 28. Culture is king. Make your company culture. And give us 5 tips for creating a good culture in your company. So guys, thank you very much. See you tomorrow for another episode. Sorry for this short episode, but it was all to do a short episode or not to do it all. And my challenge for myself is to do it. And even so, it's going to be like a really small improvement in my own eyes, but I'm still going to do it because any improvement is better than no improvement. So thank you very much, guys. See you tomorrow for another episode, the last episode of this week. And until then, have a great time and bye-bye.